hope you can hear me. This is a recording of Guild Wars 2. Hold on one second. Alright, hopefully this is the last time. Well, I don't know. I say hopefully now, but we'll see how it goes. But hopefully this is the last time I ever open Guild Wars 2. But I'm recording the game footage using a program called D3D Gear. And I'm just gonna talk about the game before I quit playing the game. For now, quit. I know I'll miss it a lot. I might even reinstall it down the line, but we'll see. I do love the game a lot. I've been having fun with it. And it does bring back a lot of World of Warcraft memories. But I guess I just burnt myself out. I played a little too much, too fast. Here's my Char Guardian, level 44, Gronk Steel. I don't know if you can see the mouse, but the guild I'm in is Legends of the Risen Dead, or Lord. I just got randomly invited into it, and I accepted. I'm like, why not? Let's see what the guilding's all about. But it's a pretty silent guild, at least in the chat. I didn't try TeamSpeak or anything. 27% map completion. I'm at Blaze Ridge Steps right now, and the server is on Yak's Bend. All of your players are on one server. When I started, I was actually in Borderless Pass. But if you look at the world versus world rankings, that was the last. They were in last place, like literally last place. So I switched to Yak's Bend, which is in tier 2, and I think it's like the 4th or 5th best server out there. Most of the top ones were all full anyway. Anyway, there's actually a mega server, is what it's called. So each different map region you go into, you can actually, you play with players from all the different servers. The only place server matters is in world versus world. Like, that's the PvP of this game, you know, where each world attacks and takes. I don't have much experience in world versus world, but yeah, there's a mega server. It just groups you with your friends and stuff. So yeah, this is my Char Guardian. Guardian's kind of like Paladin. And then I made this guy called Ziggurat. Just to reserve the name, because I had a Silvari Necromancer on another server on Borderless Pass that I deleted, so in order to transfer for free, I created this guy just as reserved name, and I thought he looked freaking awesome. Norn Thief, he's the tallest and fattest Norn out there. I just think he looks cool, so I definitely want to play. And then I might make a completely new one that just looks better and stuff, but yeah, I'm pretty happy with this guy's look. I just don't know what I picked for the decisions when you're creating the character. I just skipped through it. And then I made this guy just to reserve the name. The regular spelling of Bam Bam Bigelow wasn't around, because this guy kind of reminded me of Bam Bam, especially with the tattoos and stuff, or kind of like his fire tattoos. And then I just made these two just to reserve the name. I wanted Illmatic, which is obviously taken, but then I thought of Illmalice and thought it would be a cool name for a necromancer. But I'm not sure if I want to put a space in between Ill and Malice or not, so that's why I made both of these. For now, I'm going to delete this guy just to show the character creation screen. So these are the races. Silvari are like tree people. They're kind of like night elves. The Asura are like the little gnomes. I mean, yeah, gnomes. Norn are like Nords, pretty much. Humans, of course. And Char are kind of like the orcs of this game. So let's go human. I definitely want to make a human female too, eventually. Well, wanted to, I'm not sure. Because they just look freaking awesome. And I either want to go with Thief, Mesmer, or Engineer. That looks like Beyonce, doesn't it? Yeah, I think the humans look freaking awesome in this game. Look at that. I did have a human female warrior in my other server too, which I got pretty into. It was a lot of fun. But I'm actually having more fun with my guardian, my char guardian. So yeah, whatever, you just pick. Oh, I might do a ranger too. Ranger looks like a lot of fun to play. So anyway, you just pick all this stuff, customize, and then you pick different things depending on your class and your race. But I'm gonna go back and log into my Char Guardian here and I'll show you what it's all about. So I think my server's based in, I don't know if it's GMT or Central Time, but most of the guilds I noticed are in Central Time. So first things first, whenever I log in, you get this reward here, just for logging in. Oh man, it sucks that I've never reached here. 2 more days and I'll be here, but doesn't look like it's happening. So this is my reward for today. So I got that. And then this is the daily quests for the day. It usually gives you different random stuff. It's either a world, there's a world boss, the fire elemental event. So in this region, I'm supposed to complete 4 events. Forge, oh, Mystic Forge. I've only gotten this one time before. You just use the Mystic Forge, that's pretty much it. And then you get either, this is Forager, so I'm supposed to gather plants in this area, Ascalon.
You can never
So let me
have
tell
too
you about the
much
shortcuts
treasure.
first. First, I for inventory is the equivalent of B for bag in World of Warcraft. The new item, as you can see, is shining here that I just got. So let me open that. Okay, it gave me transmutation charges. These I can consume right away. It just puts it in my bank pretty much. So, see? That right there. One, two, three. Oh, look, I have a couple bags here too. Let's see what's in there. So, just some materials. And then the key here, you can right-click on the items to get different options. A thing you should normally do is click here and go deposit all materials, or you can do it one by one like this. But you should always be doing this, deposit all materials and then compact. And oh look, there's an event starting here right now in my thing.
Rest is for the
it
weak.
kind of sucks, but
War
oh
is
well,
for the strong.
I guess it's a good opportunity.
Enough words.
I have a bunch of these
Stay proud, Ogre.
experiences that I'm saving
Enemy
for my
contact.
new character, was saving of course.
Hey, need some help over here.
And then other shortcuts, H for hero. This is the equivalent of C in World of Warcraft for character. You got equipment, and there's all your weapon, all my stuff I have. So you know, there's head, shoulder, chest, glove, pants, boots, weapon, shield, and you can actually hold 2 different weapons. I'm not sure if there's a third one that unlocks or not, but for now I have 2. And you can either swap it like that, or if you press here, or if you press the tilde key. So let me attack this guy. Interact with objects, in this case loot, and it shows you here what you just picked up. Anyway, what other shortcuts are there? I'm already freaking brain dead. There's all the options here. Here, it says the shortcuts there too. World versus world is B, which I don't have much experience in. G is guild. O for the trading post or Black Lion Trading Company. Oh, new outfit. Cool. Ha, gay. Male inventory, I went over. H for hero. Okay. So let me talk about my warrior. Depending on what weapon you're holding, your entire skill set changes. This, of course, is your health. This is your energy, the two yellow bars. If you double tap towards a direction, it dodges, and so you have to go one way, and it slowly regenerates. It comes in real handy to get away from people. This is experience. I'm currently level 44, but the green here is my scaled level. So I'm kind of too high for this level, so it's scaling me down to that. And then, of course, if you click here, there's a different stuff, like, say, you know, guild, map, party, whatever. These are my currently activated buffs. The debuffs also show up here. I think buffs are called boons in this game, I'm still not sure. On the event just finished, the event succeeded, that's my experience, karma points, and gold. I got silver because I didn't participate too much. And what I don't like about this game is you can't inspect people. Like, I'm seeing this person, I can't right click and see what she's wearing, and I also can't see what she's currently targeted. So that's the main thing I don't like about this game that I like in World of Warcraft. Also, there's no raids. There's 5 people parties, but no raids, there's just world bosses. Actually, if you go to world boss on the Guild Wars wiki, it shows the world boss timer. And you can go to the different areas and do the world bosses. You can collect the chests from the world, from each world boss once a day. So yeah, spacebar jumps, the controls are all the same as World of Warcraft. You can actually move and cast spells at the same time, which I really like about this game. Let's see, number 6 is my heal. Alright, so these 3 are my guardian skills. You know, they're called virtues. I'm not gonna go over every attack, because it's just, there's too much to know, but it is my two-handed sword stuff, which is what this is on. It's my favorite weapon set. I'm still not really a pro with this class, but I'm just having fun with it. And then 6 through 0 are, I forget what they're called, but they're like skills. Yeah, skills. And you can unlock different ones and change it. 6 is usually your heal, the other ones are different stuff. 0, see, I have this. I think this is a racial spell. So if I switch to that, I can call in my warband. They disappear after a while. And I also have 8, which summons a sword for me. That fights by my side, kind of like my pet. That's pretty cool. So I got my own little crew right now. And see, if you switch to weapon sets, my skills change completely. Alright, so up here has your dailies. This is just the event, the main event in this area, which is the world boss. Once that changes, it means the world boss is coming up soon. I'm not sure what this is, PvP ladder or whatever. This is my story quest, which is flashing here too, telling me where to go. And this is the, I forget what it's called, but it's telling me the closest thing. As you can see on the map here, it's telling me the closest thing I need to do in this area. I have this, which helps. Number 9 grants me speed, just to speed things up, because there are no mounts in this game, which is pretty cool actually. You're forced to walk everywhere, and I don't mind at all. It's fun to walk and run and stuff.
aggression.
So this is the heart guy. You don't need to accept quest or anything like that. I'm in the area, so now I can do this stuff and complete the quest. I never even need to talk to this guy at all. And as you can see here, this is a nearby waypoint. If you press M for map, you can see. And these are the different things you can complete in each area. Oh, that's kind of cool. I didn't realize it flashes like that. I've completed 5 out of 15 hard quests in this region, Blaze Ridge Steps. 13 out of 18 waypoints. So as you can see, this is the waypoint I got. This is one that's nearby that I haven't unlocked yet. These are points of interest, which are just areas you discover. 1 out of 5 skill challenges, which you either have to fight someone or simply just commune in the area, it's called. These are vistas, which you go up into the, it's kind of like Assassin's Creed when you go up into the tower and it unlocks the view, you know. And this is a world completion, so I'm only 27% complete. If you scroll up, the map goes further out. So this whole land is called Tyria. And then there's different regions. Like right now I'm in Ascalon, I think, or Blaze Ridge, I don't know what it's a part of. And if you go closer, Plains of Ashford, Diessa Plateau are in Ascalon. And then there's Black Citadel, which is the capital of the Char. Oh, you see the red here, sounds like I'm being attacked. Who's attacking you? Yeah, like even right now, I'm not in the mood to play this game at all. Oh, this is the map, map chat right now. People are chatting in. What's this here? It's part of the hard quest. So see, it said you helped, whatever his name is. That means I completed an objective in this area. I'll probably get more. Yeah, you helped for us, this village. And this fills up slowly. Oh, that's actually part of this hard quest, which I'm not near. Interesting. And you get experience for everything in this game. For foraging, chopping wood, mining, PvP, killing people. The max level is 82, by the way. And people can hotlink waypoints. That's pretty cool. Oh, another thing I'll mention real quick is the rarity scale. So white is like common. And then it goes to blue. Do I have any blues equipped? Blue, and then green. So it's the opposite of World of Warcraft, where it goes green, blue, then red. And then after green is yellow. And then there's like pink, purple, and I think another color, which I don't have anything on me now. Oh, and there's all these stuff you can equip, like water weapons. I have no idea what that is. Why do I have 2 helmets? Is that my underwater weapon? Yeah, I'm still not totally familiar with the game. Backpack, 2 earrings, 2 rings, and a necklace. Pretty interesting, huh? So back to the map. As you can see, I've completed Plains of Ashford 100%. So yeah, that's how the regions work. And then it shows you the level area here too, 60 to 70. Fireheart Rise, huh? Iron Marches. So this one says Ascalon Forager. If you click, it tells you which regions you can. Oh, Blaze Ridge Steps is part of Ascalon, so if I forage, it'll help me complete my daily. Oh look, there's a nearby event right here. I'm gonna ignore it. I've kind of gotten burnt out of events, to be honest. Oh, if you press R, it's auto run. Another cool thing is they can't steal your stuff. Like this guy just foraged here. I can also do the same. And yeah, see, it's 25%. I got credit. Boys, take care of that hyena. There's also a bunch of achievements if you press H and go here, and you can unlock titles. You can see a bunch of people have like cool titles and stuff.
Retreat.
See, this guy's talking about Shaddy. That's the world boss in this area of Blaze Ridge Steps. I did him yesterday for the first time, actually. Yeah, the world bosses, they're kind of cool looking and stuff, but it's pretty much just a spam fest, which is what I don't like. It's kind of stupid. I got pretty bored of the world bosses real quick. Seems like a chore now. Even though I've done like less than 20 world bosses since I started playing this game. So there's no thing in the game, what do you call it, like you don't fly from different areas. Instead there's waypoints, you just click and teleport there. You can teleport all the way across the map instantly, which is cool, but at the same time it's cool to get the feeling of actually traveling there, you know. And the further it is, the more money it costs. So I just completed that daily, and I can click here. Gave me a chest of plants.
You can never have too much treasure.
So there are more plants. Let's deposit. Compact. And you can eat food in this game to get buffs. Like that one gives me that plus 10% experience from kills. Mystic Forager. I'm not going to bother with that. Fire Elemental. Yeah. I won't be able to show you world boss because I can't look up the timer right now, but yeah, it's pretty much a shitload of people there. You pretty much just show up and you get credit and it gives you a chest. There's no strategy involved really on any of the bosses that I checked out. And there's only one time we failed, and I guess it's one of the harder ones, but it's three worms you fight. So you split up into three groups and fight the worms and stuff. Oh look, this is a guild member of mine. Or is it a different lord? Because usually when someone's in your guild, they'll show up as yellow. So what else can I show? I can keep going, but that's pretty much it. I really don't feel like playing. Plus, I have to leave anyway. Oh, I like the trading post in this game. So let's say I want to. Actually, I should use this, huh? Yeah, I'll use that for what it's worth. So let's say I want to sell that. I can just right click, go sell at trading post, and instantly sell it. And then I don't get the money, but you can unlock skin, but that was account buying it to you. Oh wow, that's pretty good. If you go to a trading post guy, you can collect it. So that's pretty much it. Black Citadel is the capital of the Char. Lion's Arch is the main capital. And there's also portals here that go to the different major cities. So that's a cheap way to get around. Cheaper way. And then Divinity's Reach is the human's capital. And I don't think I've seen the other capitals. I've seen the Silvari capital. Or Radasum is the, what do you call it, the little people's capital. What are they called? Whatever they're called. Yeah, I'm kind of glad I didn't get really hooked on this game. I didn't really get to experience the social aspect either, which kind of sucks. I did pay real money for 1,000 gems. You can do currency exchange too, so I can like get gold for my what do you call it, gems. Damn, 100 gold only? That sucks. Oh, I guess I'll show. I didn't even go over crafting, but my guy is an armor smith and cooking. They say you shouldn't bother with it until you're max level 80. There's a recap of the story. The story is really cool. I mean, the way the story's done in the game and the cutscenes. But it's too bad you can't like replay the cutscenes. I've been recording it. Oh, Living World Season 2, I guess that's like a add-on or expansion. But if you come to Wallet, it'll show your stuff. I'm not sure what laurels are used for, but karma you get from doing the world events and whatever. Coins and gems, of course. Skills and traits. Skills, you get new skills, traits, you get different stats and shit. And whatever, that's pretty much it. So where am I gonna go to say farewell to this guy? Yeah, I'll consume that karma, why not? Yeah, I'll just go to one of these pay waypoints and log out there. The Char story was pretty cool. I'm part of the Ash Legion, which are like the spies. And then there's the Blood Legion, which are the warriors, and then the forget what the other one's called. But they're the technology people who make the weapons and stuff. I kinda wish I had chosen them, to be honest. And then there's the Flame Legion, which are like the shamans, and they're the enemies. But yeah, that's pretty much it. Say goodbye and log out forever. Goodbye. So that's it. Goodbye, Guild Wars 2. Thanks for the couple weeks of fun.